In this video, let us discuss how to record journal entries. We all know that journal entries are recorded based on the principles of golden rules of accounting. So without having a thorough knowledge of the golden rules of accounting, it will be difficult to understand the concept of journal entries. So initially I have explained the golden rules, and then with a few examples I have tried to explain you how to record journal entries without byhearting, by applying the principles how to record journal entries. So let's go into the video, starting with the golden rules of accounting. We all know that we have classify the accounting transaction into three types: personal account, real account, and nominal account. So what are the entries that will come under personal account, or what are the transactions that we will record using the personal account rule? If the name of a person is given, for example Ramu, Raju, like these are examples of name, any name, if the name of a person is given, then that transaction will be recorded as per the personal account rule. Even the proprietor, that means the owner of the business, is a person, because we know that the owner is different from the entity, the business is different from its owners. So the proprietor, the owner of the business, he is also a separate person, and his transactions will be recorded using the personal accounting rule. Apart from real persons, artificial persons, like if the name of a company, a corporation or bank, all these are artificial persons, their transaction will also be recorded as per the personal account rule. So what is the personal account rule? The personal account rule is debit the receiver, credit the giver. That is, if the person is receiving money, he should be debited. If the person is giving something to the business, then his account should be credited. So as per the personal account rule, if the person is receiving something from the business, then his account should be debited. If the person is giving something to the business, his account should be credited. The next comes the real account. What are the transactions that will be recorded as per the real account rule? All assets. Assets means properties of the business. All properties of the business will be recorded as per the real account rule. A few examples of assets are cash, building, furniture, even intangible assets. Intangible assets means the assets which we cannot see: trademark, patent, goodwill, and even goods, stock and trade. All these are assets, and these transactions will be recorded as per the rule of real account. What is the rule of the real account? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. That is, if the assets comes into the business, it should be debited. If the asset goes out of the business, the account should be credited. Then nominal account. What are the transactions that will be recorded as per nominal account are expenses. If the business incurs any expense, if the business spend any money, for example, rent, salaries, interest paid, all these are expenses which has been incurred by the business. And then if the business suffers any loss, I have given you an example of bad debts. Bad debts means a business cannot run only with cash transaction. If the business is giving goods on credit and the debtor is not paying you the money, even after repeated calls, repeated talking with the debtor, if you are not able to collect the money, then we will treat it as bad debt. That bad debt is a loss to the business. So losses will be recorded as per the rule of nominal account. If the business receives any income, like interest received, commission received, likewise, if the business receives any income, or the business has any gains, example, profit on sale of asset. So all expenses, all losses, all incomes, all gains, this will be recorded as per the rule of nominal account. What is the rule of nominal account? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. If it is expenses and losses, it should be debited. If it is income and gain, then that account should be credited. So this is what the golden rule of accounting is. A very simple rule. If you understand this rule, you can record journal entries without byhearting. I will explain this once again. Personal account, the entries that will be recorded as per the rule of personal account is name of a person or any artificial person. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Real account, all assets. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Nominal account, all expenses, losses, incomes, gains. So debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. If you are thorough with this rule, then we shall move on to the. Okay, now having understood the golden rules of accounting, let us see how to apply the golden rules so as to work out the journal entry. I have taken an example. Purchased goods for rupees 10,000. So this is my question. Till I become confident or till you become familiar with the golden rules of accounting, it is always better to write the accounting rules in your rough column. So we have written the accounting rules in the rough column. Now, the first step is you have to identify the dual aspect. What are the two transactions, two accounts that are affected by this transaction? Now read the transaction. Purchased goods for rupees 10,000. So for the business, the goods are purchased by paying cash of rupees 10,000. So what will happen? Goods will come to the business. We are purchasing goods and we are paying cash. So goods are purchased and cash is being paid. Okay. When we are purchasing goods, we may purchase goods, we may purchase assets, we may purchase stationery, likewise we may purchase so many items for the business. But when you are purchasing goods, you have to record it in the name of purchases. When goods are purchased, we have to record it in the name of purchases. But if you are purchasing asset, that should be recorded in the name of that particular asset itself. If you are purchasing machinery, it is machinery account. If you are purchasing furniture, it is furniture account. If you are buying stationery, then it is stationery account. If you are purchasing goods, then you should use the word purchases account. If you are selling the goods, you should use the word sales. Because this is a part of the stock and trade of the business. Goods are part of the stock and trade of the business. But the assets are held in the same name itself. Okay, first you should have a clear understanding on this. Okay, now purchases. So the two aspects that is affected in this transaction is purchases account and cash account. Okay, when goods are purchases, what happens? The goods will come into the business and we will pay in cash. When we are paying cash, what happens? Cash goes out of the business. Then you identify which account this is. Purchases, stock is a part of asset, so this is again a real account. Cash is also a part of asset, so cash is again real account. So we have to record this entry as per the rule of real account. What is the rule of real account? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So goods comes into the business, it will be debited. Cash goes out of the business, so cash will be credited. I will explain this once again. Now let us see how to record it. See, this is the template of journal. We will have a date column, particulars column, LF, debit and credit. These are the columns. In the date column, we have to write the date of the transaction. In this question, the date of the transaction is Jan 15th. So we are writing the date of the transaction in the date column. Then we have to record the transaction. So what we have decided, we have to debit purchases account and we have to credit cash account. So purchases account, the debit entry should be written near the margin. See how I have written, this is my margin. I am writing the debit entry near the margin, purchases account, and you should use the word near the LF column. LF means ledger folio. We will write the particular page number of the ledger account where we are writing this purchases ledger. So this is the page number of the ledger account, this particular ledger account. And since this purchases is debited, in the debit column I will write the amount, 10,000 rupees, I am writing it in the debit column. Then I have to write the credit entry. Credit entry should be written away from the margin, a little away from the margin. So to cash account, when you are writing the credit entry, it should start with the word to. The credit entry should start with the word TO, to. And it should be written a bit away from the margin. So to cash account, and in the credit column, since this is a credit entry, in the credit amount column, I will write 10,000 rupees. So after writing the entry, we have to give a narration. The narration should be within the brackets and it should be written within the particular column. The narration cannot exceed, go beyond the particular column. It should be written only in the particular column. And it should start with the word being. So I've started with the word being. And this narration is nothing but what is the story that has happened here? What has happened in this transaction? We have purchased goods for cash. So write it as it is. Goods purchased for cash. So this is how you have to record it in the journal. We will see one more example. We have purchased, as per this example, this is the question, purchased machinery for 50,000. As soon as you read this, you have to identify the two aspects. The two aspects are, we are purchasing machinery for 50,000, that means for cash. So machinery account and cash account are the two aspects. Dual aspect. These are the dual aspect which is affected by this transaction. Okay, we are purchasing machinery. As I already told you, if you are purchasing an asset, it should be in the name of the particular asset only. If you are purchasing goods, then purchase account should be there. Okay, now when you are purchasing machinery, what happens? The machinery will come into your business and you are paying for that machinery. When you are paying cash, what happens? Cash goes out of the business. Then machinery is an asset. All assets will be recorded as per the rule of real account. Cash is also a real account. It will be recorded as per the rule of, sorry, cash is also an asset. It will be recorded as per the rule of real account. So what is the rule? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So we are debiting machinery account and crediting cash account. Now let us see how to write it in the journal. I have written the template, date, particulars, LF, debit, credit. The date column, I have written the respective date and the debit entry near the margin. Look at the entry, how I have written it. Debit entry near the margin, credit entry away from the margin. Okay, then for debit entry, machinery account, simply machinery account is enough and write the amount in the debit column. For credit entry, start with the word to, TO, and to cash account, write the amount in the credit column. Then you have to write the narration. Within brackets, you have to write the narration and the narration should start with the word being. What has happened here? We are purchasing machinery. So being machinery purchased. I hope you understood this. So I will move on to a few more examples. Sold goods for rupees 7,000. What are the two entries that are affected in this transaction? Goods goes out of the business and we are receiving money. So sales account and cash account. As I already told you, when goods are sold, it should be recorded in the name of sales. If you are selling an asset, then it should be recorded in the name of the particular asset account. So here goods are sold, so we are recording it in the name of sales and cash is the next account. So when we are selling, goods goes out of the business and cash comes into the business. Sales, goods are part of real account. So this is real account and cash is also an asset. This will also come under real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Goods goes out, so goods will be credited. Cash comes into the business and it will be debited. When we are making a sales, goods goes out of the business and we will receive the money. So cash comes into the business. So this is how we have to record it in the journal. Write the date. Cash account should be debited. So cash account debtor in the debit column 7,000. To sales account, credit column 7,000. A small narration being goods sold for cash. The next example is sold furniture. Here we are selling goods. Here we are selling furniture. If furniture is sold, it should be recorded in the name of the particular asset. So furniture and cash are the two accounts. When we are selling furniture, furniture goes out of the business and we will receive cash. Cash comes into the business. Furniture is an asset, so it will be recorded as per the rule of real account. Cash is also an asset, so it will be recorded as per the rule of real account. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Cash comes in, so we are debiting. Furniture goes out, so we are crediting furniture. This is the entry. Cash account debtor to furniture account. write the amount in the respective debit and respective credit column. The narration is being furniture sold. The next example that I have taken is sold goods to Rajesh for rupees 5000. We have already seen a sales transaction just now. The difference between this goods sold and the previous goods sold is the previous one is an example of cash transaction. This one is an example of credit transaction. In the previous example, we sold goods for some amount. The name of the person to whom we sold is not mentioned. So that is a cash transaction. Here we are selling goods to Rajesh and he is not paying money to us. So this is a credit transaction. So when goods are sold, it should be recorded in the name of sales account, and cash did not come to the business, enter into the business. Rajesh has received the goods, but he did not pay cash. He will pay cash on a later date. How to record this? When goods are sold, goods goes out of the business. And Rajesh is the person who is receiving the goods. He has received the goods. Sales will come under real account and Rajesh will come under personal account. Name of the person is given, so this will come under personal account. So goods goes out. As per real account rule, credit what goes out, so it is credited. As per personal account rule, debit the receiver, so Rajesh account must be debited. This is how we will record it. Rajesh account debtor to sales account. Write the amount in the respective debit and credit column. You have to write the date and the narration. When we are writing the narration, it is being goods sold to Rajesh on credit. Okay, the next example that I have taken is purchased goods for credit from Shiva. We already saw how to record when goods are purchased for cash. This is for credit purchases. How to record? The two accounts that are affected is purchases account and cash was not paid. We got the goods from Shiva and we did not pay cash. So when we purchase goods, what happened? Goods comes into the business. Shiva will come under personal account. The name of person is given, so it will come under personal account. As per the personal account rule, credit the giver. Shiva is giving the goods to the business, but he is not receiving cash. So he is the giver. So he should be, as per the personal account rule, he should be, sorry, here I have written it as debited. It is credited. Shiva should be credited and purchases goods comes into the business as per the rule. Debit what comes in. So this account is a debit account. It should be debited. Okay. Now this is the transaction. Purchases account data to Shiva's account. Narration is being goods purchased from Shiva. So if the goods are sold or purchased, if it is a cash transaction, how to record the goods? If it is a credit transaction, how to record the goods? That is what we saw. The next example that I have taken is rent paid. Rent is an expense to the business. The business will meet a lot of expenses. Rent, salaries, wages, they will buy postage, stationery, discount allowed, interest paid. All these are expenses and it is paid in the form of cash. Okay, the two accounts are rent account and cash account. Rent is an expense. And cash, when we pay an expense, what happens? Cash goes out of the business. Cash will come under real account and rent, it is an expense, it will come under nominal account. So as per the rule of real account, when it goes out, it should be credited. Cash goes out, so it should be credited. As per nominal account, all expenses and losses must be debited. So we are debiting rent account. So whatever expense that we pay, rent, salaries, wages, likewise, whatever expenses we pay, the expense must be debited and cash will be credited. So this is the entry. Rent account data to cash account. Narration is being rent paid. The next example is interest received. Rent is an expense. Interest received is an income. So the two transactions, the two accounts that are affected is interest account and cash account. So interest received is an income. It will be applied as per the rule of nominal account. Cash is a real account. So as per the rule of nominal account, we have to credit all incomes and gains. So interest received will be credited. And when cash comes in, it should be debited. Debit what comes in, so it should be debited. And you have, this is how you have to record it. Write the date, then cash account data to interest received account, write the amount, narration being interest received. The next example is paid, Ramu paid cash rupees 5000. So the two entries, the two aspects are cash account and Ramu's account. So when we pay cash, Ramu paid cash, that is Ramu is paying cash to us. So Ramu is the person who is giving cash and cash comes into the business. Ramu is the name of a person, so it will be treated as per personal account. Cash will be treated as per the rule of real account. So credit the giver, Ramu will be credited, and debit what comes in, cash account will be debited. So this is how we will record it. Cash account data to Ramu's account, narration being cash received from Ramu. The next is paid cash to Raja. So business, we are paying cash to Raja. The two accounts are Raja's account and cash account. Raja, since we are paying cash, Raja is the receiver and cash goes out of the business. Raja, name of the person, it will be applied as per the rule of personal account, and cash account will be treated as per the rule of real account. So debit the receiver and credit what goes out. Raja is the receiver, he will be debited, his account will be debited, cash goes out of the business, so cash account will be credited. So we will record it in the journal, and the narration is being cash paid to Raja. So that's all with the examples for this video. I have taken cash transactions, credit transactions, personal transactions, that is personal account transactions, and purchases, sales. These are all basic journal entries. For furthermore advanced journal entries, I have uploaded another video. Look into the description box for the next video. Hope you understood what I have explained in this video. Thank you for watching.